everyone, and welcome to the season 2 premiere of After the Bell. I'm your host, Alyssa.
And I'm your host, Kenna.
We'll be giving you all the information on the Batavia community, as well as highlight plenty of sports, clubs, events, and activities that happen after the school bell rings across the BPS 101 district. Today on the show, we will be talking with the BHS Varsity Volleyball Team Captains and Sports Boosters Program.
To kick off season 2 of After the Bell, we have some exciting news. After the Bell is now teaming up with BHS Video Club. This means that our entire crew and all of our writers, talent, editors, and producers are made up of all students, making us eligible to submit an entry in the news program category at the Chicagoland Television Educators Council Video Festival that takes place in March.
On September 18th, the night of the homecoming football game, Batavia High School was presented with an NFL Golden Football. In honor of their 50th anniversary, the NFL is recognizing high schools across the nation who have contributed to the past Super Bowls. An honorary Golden Football is being presented for every player or head coach alumni who has participated in a Super Bowl. Batavia High School alum Ken Anderson was a member of the class of 1967 and was starting quarterback for the Cincinnati Bengals in the Super Bowl 16 in 1982. The Golden Football was presented in between the sophomores and varsity games on the night of the homecoming game against St. Charles East. When a rainout occurred and was completed the next morning when the Bulldogs defeated the Saints 28-0.
Coming up after the break, we're sitting down with the BHS Varsity Volleyball Captains to talk about their season.
Hi, I'm Michelle, and I'm in the Batavia High School Interact Club.
An advantage of being an Interact Club is it sets up many community service opportunities that you might not be able to find on your own.
You should join the Interact Club because it's just a fun way to get involved with the community and just have a great time with it.
You should join Interact Club because not only does it look good on college applications, but it's a great way to meet new people.
Interact Club is fun,
interesting, and a club that you should join.
Downtown Batavia, always moving by nature. Recreation. Nature. The arts. Specialty shops. Restaurants and services. Downtown is everyone's neighborhood. Come, celebrate, meet friends, unwind.
See you downtown.
Welcome back to After the Bell. Joining us now are the captains of the BHS Varsity Volleyball Team, here to talk about their 2015 season. So, just state your names, what positions you play, and what grade level you guys are.
I'm Sydney Cavanaugh, and I'm a senior, and I'm an outside hitter.
I'm Caitlin Fagan, I'm also a senior, and I'm a libero.
I'm Jenna Garrett, I'm a sophomore, and I'm a setter.
So, how's your team been doing so far, and what's your record?
Well, we just came off of a win against Elgin, which put our record to 2-2 in conference.
So what games and teams are you most specifically excited for?
We're really looking forward to our game next Tuesday, October 6th, against Geneva, because there's obviously a big rival between Batavia and Geneva. And last year we had a really tough loss to them. It was a really close game, 26-24, which is as close as it can really get by 2 points in volleyball. So we're really hoping to come and upset them this year.
Yeah, and you have to win because it's your senior year.
Of course.
And when's senior night?
It's October 21st, so it's going to be a really big deal this year. We have 7 seniors, which is more than half of the team, so we're really excited for that.
And we're playing Nequa Valley, and they're always a tough competition, so we're preparing for them.
So what's the story behind, like, your rivalry last year with Geneva?
Well, my sophomore year, we beat them, which was a really big deal because we hadn't beat them. It was the first time the seniors on the team had, like, beaten Geneva in a few years, so that was really cool. And then last year, they beat us, so it's kind of, like, our time to come back and, like, kind of get revenge on them. Like, so we're really excited for that.
Yeah. So what's your participation in the Athletes Against Hunger?
Athletes Against Hunger is a community service project that the entire program participates in. What it does is we go door-to-door collecting food for the Batavia Food Pantry, and it's a really cool opportunity because it's, like, it really helps out the people in need in the community, and, like, yeah.
Is that varsity or is it junior varsity? Is it all the teams that do that?
It's the entire program that participates.
And the person who made it up, Audrey Fallhaber, she played volleyball. She graduated in 2014. She got, like, all sports to be involved. So, like, every sport has representatives that come, and it's really awesome.
Oh, that is really
And
cool.
This year we raised over 2,000 items that we got for the people in the food pantry. So that was really cool.
Oh, wow.
So what's your guys' number one goal this season as a team?
Our goal this year is really team unity. With having a lot of younger girls and maybe like less experienced girls on the team, we're really focusing on kind of playing together and being successful with one another.
So what have you guys done for team bonding so far this year?
In the beginning of the year, before the first day of school, we have like 10 hours that we stay here at the school together as a team, and we do a lot of team bonding activities and stuff like that. And also, every day we're together as a team at practice and tournaments and games outside of school. So we get to see each other a lot, and that's a lot of team bonding.
Yeah.
What does it take to be a captain?
It takes a lot of commitment and leadership. Our coach, Trippy, she's been coaching for almost 30 years now, so it's a really big honor also to be picked by her as a captain. So it kind of takes a lot of commitment, like I said, and it's a big honor.
I agree with Sydney. It is a really big honor to be picked by Trippy to be a captain and to kind of take on this leadership role. Like, a lot of the younger girls and the people on our team, like, look up to us, and it's really cool to, like, develop this leadership quality and take on the responsibility that it takes.
And also, like, in the future, like, it prepares us for, like, anything we need responsibility or leadership for. Like, every week we meet and we discuss the progress of the team and how everything's going, so it teaches us and prepares us for the future. Mm-hmm.
So what type of fundraising have you done this year or are planning to do?
Well, every year we participate in Pack the Place, which is we try to get as many people in the gym as possible. And so sponsors really like this because it gives them a chance to, like, promote their logo. So we try to get as many sponsors as possible. And the money that we raise from them goes to, like, T-shirts or, like, jerseys and equipment. So it's, and also some of it goes to the boosters. So that's really cool too. Mm-hmm.
And then we also host a lot of tournaments at home and at the Great Lakes Center, which is in Aurora. It's really cool. Trippy, like, plans them all out, and we run them. All the girls end up working separate tournaments, and we really earn a lot of money for our program that way, so it's awesome.
So you said your coach, Trippy, has been coaching for 30 years. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, Trippy's been here for 29 years, I think it is to be exact. The first year she was here, she coached the tennis team, so it's really kind of an honor to have someone that's so, like, well-trained in volleyball and knowing what she's doing as a coach. It really gives us a lot of skill and everything like that.
So you guys were talking about sponsors before. What are, like, a few sponsors that you've had that you know of?
Kimmer's is a really big sponsor for us. Trippy's friends with the owner of it. So, and we always go there every year after we play St. Charles because it's in St. Charles. And I don't know, it varies every year. This year... Mm-hmm. We've had 11 sponsors.
Cal Joey's is one of them.
We had Innovative Sports and Pro Forest, which is, they're kind of connected. It's a lot of food places too, kind of just downtown. We're just trying to get the community, like, involved.
Good luck on your game next week against Geneva on October 6th, and thank you for being on the show with us. Coming up after the break, we'll be checking in with a senior football player to tell us more about the BHS football, their season so far, and what's to come.
The King County Chronicle is your best source for news and information, in print and online, in the Tri-Cities and Caneland.
This is Chronicle Country.
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 Hi, I'm Tom Wangler, president of Confident Air. Regular maintenance can prolong the life of your furnace and keep your energy costs to a minimum. Plus, there's less of a chance of a breakdown on a cold winter night. Your furnace needs proper care and attention to keep it running smoothly, so you don't end up paying too much for heating during the cold winter months, or worse yet, with deadly carbon monoxide poisoning. We recommend an annual inspection to ensure safe operation. Confident Air, your trusted home comfort professionals since 1992.
Caitlin Gerken here with Kanan Coffee. Kanan, what are you most excited about for this upcoming season?
Definitely just to get back at it with my guys. Of course, the biggest game of the year, Geneva, is probably the most exciting one of the year, but we have to wait till week 8 for that. But yeah, just getting back after it under those Friday night lights, it's going to be so much fun this year.
Just showing the fans, everyone around town, what we have. I think we got a lot of talent, and it's time to prove to everyone what we got.
Which opponent are you most looking forward to facing?
Oswego, obviously, week one, just to start off the year. Naperville Central, big 8A school, they're going to be good. And I kind of want to play St. Charles North. So
definitely our Naperville Central week six is definitely going to be a tough team. They're ranked highly in the state. And then Geneva, obviously, they're always our big rival, and it'll be a big game playing them.
Does your team have a mantra this year, and what's the story behind it if you guys do?
We have two, actually. One, seize the moment. Just senior year, just take everything in, make the most of it. And then rise up is our other one. Rise up to the occasion, rise up to the challenge, whatever the game is. Play our best, 110% effort every time. So.
Motion to the near side.
Ooh,
Frank.
Overhead.
Picks it up. Under some pressure, steps up, and he's going to be brought down.
For a loss.
Hand off Garrett. Garrett across the right side finds an opening to the five. Dives forward. Is he in? Touchdown, Batavia.
First blood. Up.
And the kick. End over end. Taking it about the 12.
Got some room here. Look out.
Running room. Balls loose. Batavia's got it. The Bulldogs will be back in business.
At the 20. Wow.
Big tight end in motion is Garrett. Garrett finds a seam up the middle, and Garrett is taking it in for a Batavia touchdown. Batavia capitalizes immediately on the turnover. Motion the handoff. Garrett.
Boy, is he
just
a
great vision
runner
that time, and he's in for another Batavia touchdown.
I don't know if it's
Anderson in motion. Emick rolls to his right. Stops. Throws it deep into the end zone. He's got a man. It's Coffee, I believe. Touchdown, Batavia.
There you go.
Kanan Coffee. Drop back to throw. Fade to the corner. That's Coffee.
Got it.
And he's got it. Batavia touch.
In motion is Albany's. Garrett gets the handoff. Bounces. That's Anderson. And Anderson's in for a Batavia touchdown.
Garrett punts into the open, and he dives in for a Batavia touchdown. Hands to Garrett. Garrett running room across the right. 10, picks up a block, ducks back into the 5.
He's in.
Takes it in for a Batavia touchdown. What a run by Zach Garrett. And we're an extra point away from. Normal pitch fake going for the corner of the end zone, and it's a touchdown. Kanan Coffee.
Beautiful, beautiful move by Coffee on that.
Flea flicker under some pressure, and he goes down. Hammering back to throw. He's under pressure. Throws it up for grabs. That one is going to be picked off.
There we go.
Quick throw. He's got a man wide open. Stuttle.
Nobody's there.
Nobody within 20 yards of him, and Stuttle will take it in for a Batavia touchdown. So it took less than a minute for Batavia to answer. Hand off Thomas. Thomas across the left side.
He's in.
Very close. Touch.
And we have heard that there was a move.
That's Anderson, and he takes it in for a Batavia touchdown. So Batavia after. And Thomas in motion. Nemec keeps it through the middle of the line, and he's going to dive in for a Batavia touchdown. Nemec quick throw over the middle, and that is caught for a Batavia touchdown.
Beautiful.
Big tight end, Glenn Allman.
Now we would like to welcome one representative of the Sports Boosters program. Welcome.
Just if you could introduce yourself and tell us what you do for the Sports Boosters.
My name is Lisa Farley. I've been with Sports Boosters for about 5 years now, and I do a little bit of everything, but my main focus is the marketing and the PR and sponsorships and concessions this year. So I got my hands on a little bit of everything.
So what is Sports Boosters and what it does for student athletes?
The Sports Boosters was started by parents to raise money for the athletes and really for some of the items that are above and beyond the regular budget. We do provide all of the uniforms for the athletes. We do a lot for the middle school as well. So it's both for the high school and the middle school athletes.
So just what is the website and what does it have on it?
We started a website. We've had one for a few years, but the last couple of years we've really upgraded it. So it does quite a bit. So people can go to our website to buy spirit wear, some of the spirit wear that you see, the blankets, the big thing of the yard signs, the bulldogs you see in the yards and the sports signs, that's where that comes from. So our website is www.bataviabulldogboosters.org. We also have on there all of our activities, our dinner dance, so people can get tickets for all of those things. So that has been really increased all of our awareness, our memberships. We've been able to sell out our last couple of dinner dances because people are able to order tickets ahead of time. So that's been really, really nice.
Where can people get spirit wear that like goes towards the Booster Club?
There are two organizations in town that we've teamed up with. In the past, the Boosters has handled a lot of spirit wear, and it's a very challenging thing for one nonprofit organization to do. So a couple of the organizations in town work with us. Boomba is one of them. Boomba's over on Randall Road. They have quite a bit of spirit wear, and they give 10% back to the Boosters on any spirit wear they sell. And then Johnny Zapka with Spirit Corner does a lot of the bling that you see. I know she does a lot with the dance and the cheer. So she does a lot of the bling spirit wear. We have links to both of those organizations on our website. They both give 10% back. Those are the only two organizations in town that give 10% back to the Boosters. So we work real closely with them. You'll see them at some of the football games selling their product. We do carry, the Boosters organization does carry a few items, but and we do carry the yard signs. Those are still part of the Booster organization. But some of the other things are just too hard for the Boosters to do in-house. So we farmed that out. But the rest of it you can buy online. The stadium chairs, those can be customized. And then the a few of the sweatshirts and t-shirts, and then the yard signs.
Also, how much have you guys raised so far this year?
That's a great question. This year, because concessions is a big part of our income, the game that was rained out a couple of weeks ago, we're not going to count that game, but that will hurt us a little bit. But we will have a couple events we haven't done before. The wrestling will have its sectionals here, and so we'll be able to raise some money with concessions. And then cheerleading will host an event, and we'll be able to raise concessions. So one of the things that we've tried to do is at the end of the year in April, the coaches come to us with a wish list. And so whatever money we've raised that year, we're able to give out. Last year, we raised close to $300,000. We're able to give over $100,000 back to the athletes in the form of wish list items as well as scholarships. So I'll talk a little bit about the wish list items. The coaches come to us in April with their wish lists. Every team gets something. So some people think it's just football. It is not just football. Every single one of our teams gets something. If it's maybe just $600 worth of travel, that may be all that they need that year. We give money to both the middle school comes to us with wish list items as well as the high school coaches. And so whatever money we have, we look through that wish list and make decisions on what are the most necessary items. And the coaches do prioritize them for us. And so that makes our job a little bit easier. The last two years, we have approved some cheerleading mats. And it was a fairly costly investment. But what it allows the cheer club to do, or the cheer organization to do, is host some competitions. And so this year they will be doing that. And so in turn, we will raise money with concessions. So we keep that in mind when we are approving these wish list items. But all of the teams get some kind of travel. A lot of the teams have asked for things like the cross country team got an iPad one year so that they could do some things. So cross country's needs are different than some of the other sports. So we approve those, and then all of them get uniforms. We do those on a rotation every 3 years. And then we have scholarships. I mentioned that. We give away 10 scholarships to student athletes each year, each worth $1,000. So that's $10,000 worth of scholarships. And that's been very successful for us. Student athletes, can apply for that scholarship, and it's really a drawing, so it's not based on all of the credentials that you might have to go through with other scholarships. It's a drawing. There are some minimum requirements, and again, all those things are found on our website. I think last year we had over 40 people apply for that, so that is a nice little bonus if somebody can get an extra $1,000 for college their senior year. So we do encourage anybody who's a senior who has been a student athlete to look into that, because it's a great scholarship, and it's not based completely on merit. It's we appreciate the athletes and what they do, and so it's one way for us to give back.
So for the sports boosters, you said you help with travel, so like buses and how people get places?
That's a great question. The school budget covers most of that, but most of these athletes do a big tournament out of town where they have to stay in hotels and get extra funds, and so we give money toward that. So every team gets about $600 worth of travel expenses kind of automatically, and then anything above and beyond that they need, they put on their wish list.
Yeah. What are some key events and fundraisers the boosters hold?
We do the dinner dance each spring. That's been really, really successful the last 2 years. We've broken some records there, raising $50,000 just in that one event. We have another event coming up called the Harlem Ambassadors versus Batavia's Dream Team, and that will be October 11th, Sunday, here at the high school. That will include some of our teachers and coaches doing a Globetrotter-like event where they play basketball with a fun kind of comedic basketball theme. So that should be fun. That's at 5:30, and tickets for that are available on our website. We'll also be selling those at the football game coming up this Friday.
Oh, sorry. Last question. How can someone join if they want to become a member?
That's a great question. We have four different levels of membership. $30, and that's just a basic membership. There's a premium membership for $100. There's a $150 membership for, that's mostly for football. It's called the Crimson membership, and that gets people in the end zone during the football games. And then we have a $225 membership, which is our gold membership. Our $100 memberships and above allow, you get a pass, and that allows you to get into all of the events throughout the year except for tournaments and playoffs. So it pays for itself for parents, especially if they have a kid in more than one sport or more than one child in athletics. And then our Crimson membership and gold membership also includes the end zone down at the football field during our home games. So all those can be found online, and we usually are at some of the first basketball events and football events at the beginning of the year.
Okay, thank you so much for coming
on the
show.
Thank you for inviting me.
Coming up after the break, Kenna and I will tell you some homecoming highlights and BYF's nights under the lights. Thank you again.
I joined freshman year because I needed a community service hours, and it was a good opportunity to like show leadership.
Student Council helps organize our school and provides fundraising to help support the community.
We organize dances and fundraisers, and we also make important decisions about the school.
I like having a student council because I know I can rely on the students to make important decisions around the school.
It's a lot of fun. It's a great way to meet new people, and also it looks great on college applications.
The Drendel & Jansen's Law Group has practiced law in Aurora since 1961 and in Batavia since 1994.
We focus our energy on representing people and businesses and families in the local community.
We represent clients in Kane and surrounding counties in matters ranging from divorce to wills, business law to zoning.
We focus our efforts on planning and working towards positive resolutions for businesses and families.
When clients need someone to fight for their interests, we're ready, willing, and able to act as aggressive advocates to protect their interests.
Drendel & Jansen's Law Group, with offices in Batavia and Aurora, and located on the web at batavialaw.com.
On October 7th and 14th, Batavia Youth Football will be holding their seasonal night games. All night games will be played at the West Main Baseball and Softball Outfields. Third and fourth graders will play their night games on Wednesday, October 7th, with a rain date of Thursday, October 8th. Fifth and sixth graders will play their night games on Wednesday, October 14th, with a rain date of Thursday, October 15th. On both nights, the first game will start at 6 p.m. and the second games at 7:30 p.m.
A new school dance policy was put into place this year, changing rules and regulations for homecoming. To enforce this new policy, students and parents were required to submit an online signature recognizing the policy in order to be allowed into the dance. The new policy changed some of the dancing regulations, stating there was no inappropriate dancing such as grinding or twerking was permitted. When students arrived at the dance, they were given a wristband to wear. Violating the school dance policy would result in a warning, and a second offense would result in the wristband being taken off and students being asked to leave the dance. The new policy raised some questions about student attendance to the dance, but there seemed to be a comparable amount of students to previous years. Although the new rule and regulations of the policy did not completely terminate inappropriate dancing. They did keep it to a lesser amount.
Congratulations to Batavia High School alum Noah Frazier for being named a finalist in the 2015 Foundation School Scholar Athlete Awards. Frazier currently plays football at Wheaton College and was chosen in the top 40 finalists out of 3,500 candidates nationwide. The finalists are all graduates of 2015 and are currently playing college football and were chosen based on academic achievement, athletic accolades, and community involvement. These awards have been some of the most prestigious high school honors in the entire country. In the end, there will be 5 student athletes given this award, one from each region of the country. These names will be announced on October 5th and will be honored at the NFF Awards Luncheon in New York City on December 8th, 2015. Good luck, Noah!
The Batavia High School dance team, coached by Angela Fuquay, had some pretty outstanding accomplishments this past summer. In July, the dance team traveled all the way to Cedar Rapids, Iowa, to compete in the Elite Universal Dance Association Dance Camp. Their performance at the camp awarded them at a superior rating for both varsity and junior varsity. By receiving this rating, they are now qualified for the UDA National Competition, which will take place in Walt Disney World in January of 2016. In addition to this, they also kept busy volunteering in the Batavia community. In June, they ranked in the top 3 fundraisers for cancer research at Relay for Life and raised money and food donations for Batavia Interfaith Food Pantry. Congratulations, ladies.
After the Bell still needs crew members. If you are a student with an interest in television and would like to be a part of After the Bell, please contact BATV at atb@mybatv.com.
That's all for our show today, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to After the Bell. I'm your host, Alyssa.
And I'm Kenna. And that's what happens after the bell.